We look forward to listening to his message, and we request him to chair the session too. It's an honor to welcome Mr. Mahesh Sharma. We request him to accept a bouquet of flowers as a token of our respect and gratitude. May I once again invite Dr. Y.S. Rajan to speak to us.
Good morning, everybody. Distinguished persons in the dais, the teachers, principals, and I think there were some students also. There are some students, I saw them there in that place. To all of you, my sincere thanks for giving this opportunity to interact with you. I am going to sit through the whole day because many of you will be asking. I am come here mainly to learn. And also it is a great pleasure because Dr. Kushal always takes these initiatives. And for me also personally, it was very good because I was preparing for some major write-up and talk for Institute of Chemical Technology regarding technology transfer. You know, all these words have all become obsolete now, even though you will find it a lot. But it does exist, but they all got conglomerated into something called learning economy. So I have been trained by some teachers, right from even in Bombay University, which is there. They will always tell you what they are doing. So I have taken a lot from innovation policy in global economy, Cambridge University. I have been reading quite a bit, but I am going to say something on this because as Dr. Kushal was mentioning, you would have heard agriculture, pastoral economy, agricultural economy. Even pastoral economy has thrown lot of wisdom because many of those axial period, whether Rigveda there or in those areas, Zendavastha, all that had come in those period. Then agriculture, it is a transition towards agriculture, it came from pastoral to agriculture. Then industrial. Then you have heard Renaissance, science and all those things, etc., etc. Then we had a series of them, though we talk only about IT, series of them like atomic energy, space, they were all the outcome of those scientific and technological ones. Then they were at such a rapid pace, we don't even know which one to say when. When biotechnology took, when IT took, when this one took, when ICT took, we don't know. Then the glass technology of this one has gone into fiber optics, which giving a heavy run for space. See, I entered into space, the thick routes were available only through space. But now, some ordinary wire, some fellow hooks, because there was a problem of joints there, they solved that also. Now it is so complex a world, it's not only IT, manufacturing technologies have got into so much of revolution. Something nano, not the nano car, but the nano world has opened up new possibilities in almost every field. What happens is, multiple of these divergences come. Even while you are all science teachers, science and technology will continue to have a core role in any of the knowledge. Because nowadays you read in the newspapers, they will put it as if innovation can be done anywhere. It is not true. Occasionally one can say, one sachet which was there in a bottle was made into small and then you gave. That's okay. That is after that shampoo has been made. So the basic science and technology core and that knowledge and those efforts will come. However, it cannot remain in isolation. That is one thing which you have to do. Even within itself, it cannot remain in isolation. I was just talking to Dr. Kushal. Can you tell me how many scientific or technological knowledge bases are here in this? Where you will characterize? This is a mobile. What is it? E71 of Nokia. What does it contain? How many? Just teachers have to tell also. Sometimes questions are put to the teachers. Just say where it belongs. Which one? Which technology, communication, this, so you will characterize something, no?
Electric 3G.
This doesn't contain 3G. 3G is going to come. Maybe this will be compatible, I don't know. But that will be a software. Okay. 3G, 2G, electronics, then communication. Manufacturing, what manufacturing?
Circuit board
manufacturing, then
programming.
Software, programming is software, okay. Then
internet.
Is there any chemistry at all in this? Silicon based, silicon is more like metallurgy. Battery. If the battery is not the advanced chemical technologies have not gone in, you will be having a mobile of this size. Now you are able to do 36 hours, we are able to speak, is because there are so many. There is a magnet. That small little magnet, very, very high density magnet, rare earth magnet. If that is not there, it won't be this small. It will be this big. Then, see the paint there. See the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They are the crucial for it in this, if it is to be utilized. No, it is not alphanumeric. That paint, you can talk alphanumeric, etc. If that, you know, how many times you do, how much abuse you do to it. You keep it here, sweat. How many times you keep, in the end of it, that paint won't go. That adhesion of that paint and then the amount of chemical and scientific and other knowledge, including adhesion physics, which would have gone in. Touch screen. Yes, there is another one. Then even this joints, this plastic, the joints, if any one of you have ever wetted a mobile, somewhere it has put in a bathroom, you carry with your wetter, then you take it out, it is not easy. The amount, if you take it out and then see back, so this approximately will contain 150 different types. Then comes other aspects of ergonomics. How you like it, how this one like, it went very small for at one point of time. Then people, they found that putting this is a problem. Then they started becoming more. So ergonomics is there, how you attract. So in other words, there are so many things involved in such a thing. Then you imagine a bigger one. Even here, there will be 10 technologies. In a glass which you just take tea, there will be 7 or 8 technologies. So you should remember that there are several things which are confluencing. Because by nature of practice, we all get into one subject. We have to do it super speciality there. But if you forget that all other worlds doesn't exist, then you are gone. This is a thing, it may be good for you to inject into the children right from the beginning, whomsoever you teach, and also to yourself. Now I will quickly say a few things. What is this learning economy? You have heard the word all that, then came all this multiplicity of knowledge, they called it as knowledge economy. That is a word, because these words are all not coined by technologists. These are all coined by economists. They only say that this is the thing, because science and technology fellows are busy doing it. Business fellows are making money out of it. Then economists will study what is happening, etc. So they use the word knowledge economy and the management gurus. So then what happens is they now say it's no longer worthwhile calling it as knowledge economy, because knowledge means what has been got from all accumulating there. Then what happens is you sit for 3 years, you ask any of the very actively working scientists, technologists, they will not leave that particular one or some other topic. If they take off for 3-4 years, they suddenly will find they have become obsolete. Then they can't compete again. The same thing with businesses. So therefore, what is to be done is learning economy. It's not only for the science and technologies, to the technicians, to the officers, the whole management systems will change. Management systems with all the high definition TV and then the earlier TV systems are different. Now with 100 channels coming, the studios are not done the same way what Doordarshan used to do years ago. Everybody is in trouble. Newspapers are struggling how to do. So everybody has to learn. So this learning thing, so ability to make the totality of the learning as a continuous process, and that is what is going to mark what is coming now. What is going to be after 25 years, I don't know. Learning means also unlearning. Something will go, something will come, something will go. This ability to give is important. But is all good? Is it all good? All learning, learning, learning. So you people will have more jobs. more this thing? Is it all good? It's good, but it also has negative aspects. The negative aspect is those who are not willing to learn, they are out. If you see the labor markets all in India itself, let us take Tata's, one of the best employers. If you see, about 30, 40 years ago, about 75% of the Tata's thing will be illiterate, unskilled labor. 25 will be educated, and then within that, BA, etc. will be very low. Now, if you see the same empire, it has got steel. It is not only TCS. Steel, Tata Gardens, and everything together, the ratio is reversed. So, whole worldwide, the labor market is changing to a point that if you are illiterate, you don't have, not only illiterate, literate, you don't have special skills, you are out. So, this is a thing which you have to look at very carefully, as to how to see how much you can include people into the learning process. That is the challenge of the new pedagogy. Because here itself, these fellows have given something. The old pedagogy, he just says that the methods used in teaching today results in a large number of young people and adults falling by the wayside in the process. Guillotines. They are all guillotined out. And the Indian system, of course, is atrocious. If they kill 20 people, we kill 100 people. Because of our systems, which are extremely rigid and extremely, no flexibility, they don't trust teachers. Because the teacher will know this boy or girl can do this, you can't give it. Because some CBSE said it or somebody said it, some exam will come, somebody will say this is the answer which is to be given. Because otherwise you are not in the objective test. So you have a problem. But even in this is for the Western society itself, which is much more flexible, result in a large number of young people and adults wayside of the process. Radical new thinking which places learning, including learning through practice, in a more central role in people's working lives, and which also opens up a large range of unconventional measures with respect to the structure and content of the teaching is necessary to tackle these problems. Okay, then I am not going to tell all of it. Then there is a very beautiful thing told by one gentleman. The knowledge economy, he just says a lot of complexities there. There is one economist who is a Nobel Prize winner, Arrow. Now he says, what is it? When will people pay for? What will you pay for? Something you think that it is good. Then you are ready to pay one dress more money than other money. They both look apparently similar, but you see some certain things. So in the knowledge economy, one of the things which is going to be very difficult is that how do you judge? People will pay for the knowledge which they don't have. Correct? If you have some 4 saris already, that one particular Orissa type, then you don't buy it. Then you go for some other thing. So you do what you don't have. But the problem is how to know whether the person is having or not. So this is the problem of going to be in the learning society. Why I am saying it is, the much of the learning, the real learning in science, technology and actual businesses, marketing and all these things is what is called as tacit knowledge. Codified knowledge is this book. But many of it, what I am telling, is because I have the tacit knowledge in me, because I have struggled through, got beaten up in the system. Because you learn only getting beaten up in the system. Because also you would know how it is. The science and technology side, Dr. Dhar and all will know. So we get beaten up. That becomes the tacit knowledge. You get beaten up in teaching. That is your tacit knowledge of teaching, which cannot be written in any number of symposia. You should have a method of imparting it. There again he says, they go further. It says, trust becomes a very important material or commodity in the learning economy. It's no longer money. It's no longer PR. It's going to be trust, because you will learn only from people whom you trust. Because that knowledge asymmetry, you believe that this person is going to give you a knowledge which you don't possess. So that trust has to be developed. Again, there is a very beautiful thing. Again, he quotes that arrow. Trust is something which cannot be bought. So the economist itself is going to get into a problem, because the economist can know how to